Hello friends, welcome to Azure video tutorials. Today's session I am going to give an introduction to Azure Databricks and a history about Databricks as well as walk through the architecture, Azure architecture. So let's start with the history about Databricks, who started this company and when it started. So Databricks is a company founded by original creators of Apache Spark. So these guys, Apache Spark developers initially who developed this Apache Spark and as a project. So they developed this application. It's a browser based or you can say a web based application. This can be integrated in a cloud, Azure or AWS, Amazon AWS. There, if you have a requirement like data scientist requirement or data engineer requirement or data analyst requirement, like if you want to do some analysis or if you want to do some data ingestion and transformations like a ETL tool or business analyst data. So this all type of requirements you can do in a single click in browser based application that is called Azure Databricks. So it is a Apache Spark based modern analytics platform. Like if you have any data scientist requirement or data engineering requirement or data analyst requirement, all this type of stuff you can do in browser based application that is called Databricks. It is available in both Microsoft Azure Cloud and Amazon AWS Cloud. So let's start with the architecture. So this complete data flow architecture, how it looks like if you are going to use Azure, what are the sources who are going to use and where it will store and what are the features and the components. Let's look here who are going to use this. People, data science team, like if you have data science requirements, you can use this. Data engineering team, line of business, any data analyst part, anything if you have requirement you can use this. And complete components, like if you're looking at Azure Databricks components, these are the components. Workspace, Databricks workspace means where multiple developers and multiple domain related people, they can share a common workspace. And you can maintain the security here, that is available option. Like you can integrate with Azure Active Directory. Like the few people are working in data science team, few people are working in data engineering team, and a few people are working in data analyst team. But again, there is a dependency between each analyst, data engineer and data scientist, right? So if they are working individually and if other person is expecting some data or expecting some input or something, what they can do, again, they need to request and it's time consuming process, everything. So if you are looking at the Databricks workspace, it's a common workspace. Multiple people can share this workspace. For example, if you are working on some Python code and if you are doing some data analysis as a data engineer to provide some input data to data scientist. So directly you can develop one notebook and you can give to that notebook to data science team. So they can directly use that and they can develop their own based on your input. So like that, multiple people can, like the same team, data engineering team, if you have multiple people also working, is there any dependency? If you want to look at a review or something, everything you can use as a common workspace. And multiple folders you can maintain, data scientist folders, data engineering folders, like multiple folder structure also you can maintain here, and you can maintain all the code in Databricks workspace. It's a common workspace where you can create a notebooks. That's they are giving one option. And Databricks workflows. Workflows is nothing but a jobs where you can schedule whatever you have developed notebooks. So notebooks is nothing but a here Jupyter. If you are working already Python or something, you will be knowing this Jupyter, right? So the Jupyter, they integrated in Azure Databricks and they added multiple features like comments running and other benefits. They added that, like review, if you are reviewing that, you can provide the comments, running multiple commands. So there are multiple plenty of features that are available, and shortcuts also is available if you are going to use notebooks. And that's the workflows where you can schedule the jobs. And Databricks runtime is nothing but a cluster where you can create a clusters. Then Databricks IO, so input output. So when you are writing data, when you are reading data, so does DBFS. So DBES is a Databricks Enterprise Security, and DBFS is a Databricks file systems, where whatever you are doing, this all this data transformation, everything will be stored, right? So those you can store in any of the blob storage, like here this file system they mentioned, right? So Azure Databricks, those data, whatever you are doing this data, you can store into any of this, like you can directly integrate this data to, you can store into Azure Blob Storage, Azure Data Lake Store, like version 1 and version 2 both you can use, and Azure SQL Warehouse, and Kafka, and HDFS. So, as well as they are giving one more thing called a new option called Delta Lake. So Data Lake here is right, and there is another one called Delta Lake. So you'll be getting more features related to identifying incremental data, that's called Delta Data. So that Delta Lake having good features you can use in Databricks. So other than that, Databricks serverless. So Databricks serverless means when you are creating any servers, configuring any servers, so it is time consuming and more technical stuff. It's admin stuff, right? So if you are working as a data scientist or data engineer or data analyst, you don't know all this stuff, but you need to contact again administrator where they can create this stuff. But here it's a single step. So there is a pools available. That pools concept is you can create a pool whenever it's required, it will create on the fly. It's like auto scaling option. How much is required, it will create the clusters. Once it's done, it will reduce the number of CPUs. So that's called, it will reduce the nodes, number of nodes, like how many nodes you are going to use that particular session. It's like auto scaling option. If you're not using, then it will reduce. That's called serverless. So if you look at this, how a serverless architecture it looks like. So if you are going for current Spark environment, what we are doing, so you are creating a servers, right? Nodes, multiple nodes you are creating. So this is a low optimization and complex user per config. So as a developer, as an analyst, it's very difficult to configure all this thing, and it's a time consuming process. So if you are going for Databricks, what it's a single clicks, so you don't need to do anything as a technical stuff. It's a UI based, you can create a pools. So when you are running a particular task, so it will be automatically that this option like auto scaling, it will tuning your security and other things. That's called a best features it is giving. That's optimal performance and minimal cost. So if you're not using, see here, if you're not using, but amount will be calculated, right? Those are 20 CPUs and 10 GB RAM. Here one CPU, 8 GB RAM, and here 30 CPU off heap. So these, all these things, everything will be calculated if you're not using also. But here, if you're not using, okay, this auto scaling option is there, right? It will go down. If you are using, it will increase that number of nodes based on your load. This is called serverless architecture. So Databricks is a serverless. So it's an option available here, there, that I will show you in future sessions, how to create a pools. That's called a serverless architecture. Then data loads. So what are the types of data loads you can do here? So normally if you are working any ETL tool, you will be knowing all these things, right? That's called batch loads. Whenever you are receiving data, those data you are loading based on your data arrival time and everything. That's called batch load. So batch load is a normal process. So you will be receiving all batch data and using Azure Data Factory. There you can load to first Azure Data Lake. That's one option, or directly you can load into Databricks. I will show you next how to load directly to Databricks. So this is one option. The other one is streaming data. So if you want to analyze your streaming data, live data, so there Azure is providing called Azure Event Hubs. That Event Hubs will be connected to your streaming application, like any Twitter or any other application, streaming application, it will be connected and it will get the data and it will store into Azure Databricks. There you can use all machine learning libraries and you can implement whatever you have a requirement. Then that data you can push to final data to any of the reporting tool directly, like here you can see any Power BI, or you can push to any data warehousing database like Cosmos DB or SQL DB, and any apps that they can use this, they can connect to database and they can use this called, you can use as a batch processing, you can use this Databricks, a live streaming also you can use this Databricks. So let's see one example how to connect live streaming. So here this processing, how it will connect to whatever you have a sources, like if you have a source one data and source two, there are two sources. So this Azure Event Hubs will be connected to those, and it will get the data and it will store into Azure Databricks. And there you will do all the stuff. That's called, you will be creating notebooks, and the notebooks will be scheduled. There you can monitor all these jobs that you can see in a dashboard. And those data, finalized data, you can move to any of the database, or directly you can connect to analytics tools like Power BI or any visualization tool. So this is a multiple options available. So based on your requirement, you can use this. This is a common scenario where we can go for streaming data, live streaming data. So if you look at this, Twitter. So we will be creating one notebook, that API will be connected to Twitter, and the same notebook again, it will be triggered to Azure Event Hubs. There it will download the data, that live data, and again we'll be creating another notebook, consumer notebook, where it will do all the process, whatever you have a ML implementation, and that data you can store into Azure Databricks. These all these data processed inside this Spark, but after that you can store into any of the databases, or you can store into Azure SQL DB, or you can store into a Delta Lake, or anywhere you can store those data, and any reporting tool can be accessed. So this is the way we can go for using streaming data and other requirements like batch load, as a data scientist or data engineer or data, like multiple requirements, and you can use, like multiple people can be used this Databricks. So this is the complete overview and introduction to Azure Databricks. And I told you there is another option, like instead of storing data into data lake or something, so direct access also available. Like these all the data sources, if you say if the data available in HDFS or any of these sources, there are two ways. Directly you can access this data into Databricks using JDBC, ODBC APIs, or through ETL process. Through ETL process means you can use any of the languages like Python or Scala. These three languages are supporting your Databricks. So you can use whichever language you are comfortable and you are have a good on those languages. So those you can use, and with the ETL process also you can use this. You can import the data as a data processing. So this is like direct also is available. Directly you can connect the sources, systems, and you can get the data. Another way is through ETL process. So ETL process means temporarily you will be storing into one of this staging tables or any of the data lake or block storage. From there again you will be doing all this your stuff. This is the another option. So this way you can go for using Databricks for your data engineering or data analyst part or machine learning or data scientist part. So thank you for watching my videos. Please subscribe my channel to get more videos and updates on my channel. Thank you very much.